ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت، بيده الخير، وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. صدق الله العظيم. During the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina, after both battles of Badr and Uhud, a group of companions were captured, and all of them were killed except one, who was taken hostage and sold to the Meccans. His name is Khabib, or Khubayb ibn Adi. And one of the Meccans bought him because his father was killed in Badr and he wanted revenge. So they asked Khubayb, would you give up your deen? He said no. So they decided to kill him, and kill him in a brutal manner by crucifying him. So they built a cross using the branches of palm trees and tied him to it. And before they are about to kill him and cut him to pieces, literally, he was asked, would you like to be safe in your home with your children and your wife, and instead Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being in your place? He said, absolutely not. By Allah, I wouldn't love to be in my family. I wouldn't love to have all the blessings of this dunya and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam suffer the pick of a thorn, alayhi salatu wassalam. And that was the last thing he did or said before being killed. What kind of love he had for the Prophet, alayhi salatu wassalam. During the battle of Uhud, another companion, Sa'd ibn al-Rabi' from the Ansar, at the end of the battle, 70 of the Muslims, of the Sahaba, companions, were martyred, and many were injured. So Rasulullah sent people to check who died, who's injured, who's still alive. And they found Sa'd ibn al-Rabi' literally between life and death. And they asked him, Sa'd, you know, are you okay? He said, no, I am about to die. But his last words were the following. أنا مع الأموات, he told the person who came to check on him. ولكن أقرئ رسول الله مني السلام وقل له جزاك الله خيرا ما جزى نبيا عن أمته وقل لأصحابه لا عذر لكم إذا خلص إلى نبيكم وفيكم عين تطرف. Give salam to the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam and tell him, may Allah reward you greater than any prophet for his ummah. And tell the companions, do not let any harm come to the Prophet as long as you have an eye that blinks. This is a man, again, about to die, and these are his last words. But his heart is full of love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When much later, actually during or after the time of, just before the Fath of Mecca, the father, elderly man of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Uthman ibn Quhafa, accepted Islam. Very old man, his 80s or 90s. So Abu Bakr took his father to take shahada with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And Rasulullah felt sorry for them and he said, Ya Abu Bakr, you should have left the older man in his home and I would go to him. He said, no, Ya Rasulullah. He deserved to walk to you. You do not deserve to walk to him. And after taking shahada and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam congratulating Abu Bakr for his father accepting Islam, Abu Bakr said, Ya Rasulullah, by Allah, I knew how much you love your uncle Abu Talib. Allah knows, I wish he accepted Islam and not even my father. Because I wish you would have been happier if Abi Talib accepted Islam. And I want your happiness more than the salvation of my own father. Sawad ibn Ghaziyya was one of the soldiers in Badr. And the Muslims were in tough situation. 300 facing over 1,000. So the matter required discipline. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was lining up the companions. And Sawad was stepping out of line. So Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam touched him with his stick in his tummy and said, just go back, stay in line. So the man said, أَذَيْتَنِي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, you have hurt me, Ya Rasulullah. I need justice. And everyone looked at the man, what justice? Are you crazy? But he insisted. So the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, no problem. Here is the stick. You poke at my stomach the same way I did at yours. Alayhi salatu wasalam. So the man hugged the Prophet and kissed his tummy instead of hitting him. And Rasulullah said, why did you do that? He said, we are about to enter the battle. I do not know if I'm going to live or die. I want the last thing to do is to touch you, Ya Rasulullah. What kind of love Sawad had for Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rabi'a ibn Ka'b al-Aslami, a very poor man, he had no home, used to live in the masjid, and used to serve the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Bringing his wudu, staying at his door, anything the Prophet alayhi salam want, logistics, he would handle it. So the Prophet never let a favor go by without repaying it. So he said, Salni ya Rabi'a, ask me, make a wish ya Rabi'a. That young man was very smart. He said, this is a very important decision, Ya Rasulullah, give me time. I'm not just gonna wing it. And he thought about it. He said, dunya is short, asking for anything in this dunya doesn't matter. So he went back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, I love your company, Ya Rasulullah. I want to accompany you in this life and in Jannah. Rasulullah said, who told you about this? He said, no one. I just miss you so much whenever I don't see you. He said, awa ghayra dhalik, nothing else, Ya Rabi'a. He said, nothing else, Ya Rasulullah. Your company in this life and in akhirah. So the Prophet said, okay, Ya Rabia, I'll make dua for you, but just help me by making a lot of prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salma ibn al-Mu'ammar, young man in Mecca, the day Rasulullah entered Mecca, Bilal stood on the top of the Kaaba and started making adhan. He had a beautiful voice, but he was from Abyssinia, right? So he had a little bit of a, you call it, his Arabic was not perfect. So Salma had a beautiful voice, and he started making fun of Bilal. So Rasulullah ﷺ heard him, and he knew, they told him he has a good voice. So he said, would you like to make adhan instead? Would you like to be the muadhin of Mecca? The young man said, yes. So the Prophet ﷺ started teaching him adhan kindly. And Salma later said, after he became the muadhin of Mecca, because the Prophet ﷺ went back to Al-Madinah, if it wasn't for the offer and the kindness of the Prophet, I would have stayed today in state of shirk, state of disbelief. He saved me, alayhi salatu wassalam. People who committed the most horrible, heinous things against the Prophet, alayhi salatu wassalam, like Hind bint Utba, the wife of Abi Sufyan. She's the one who promised Habashi salvation from slavery if he killed Hamza, the uncle of the Prophet ﷺ, and almost his twin brother. They were raised together. And after Hamza was killed, she's the one who cut his ears and nose and his tummy and took his liver and chewed on it. Horrible things. Someone doing that to your most beloved. Then came the conquering of Mecca. And one day after Abu Sufyan, her husband, believed, she hid her face until she met the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and said, Assalamu alayka ya Rasulullah. I am Hind, the woman that did all of that to you. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forgot and forgave everything she did and accepted Islam, her Islam. Because of the kindness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hind said, Wallahi, ma kana ahlu khiba'in ahabbu ilayya min an yudhallu min khiba'ik. Wa laqad asbaht wa ma ala al-ardi ahlu khiba'in ahabbu ilayya an ya'izzu min khiba'ik. I hated your household so much, I wish Allah would humiliate them. Today, I love your household so much. There is no household more beloved to me. I wish Allah to honor them. Why Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left such an impact on everyone he met? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. You have received a messenger from amongst you. He's concerned for your suffering. He's anxious about your well-being. He's gracious, merciful to the believers. That is the description of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then in Ali Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. It was the mercy of Allah that made you so lenient to them. And if you were cruel or hard-hearted, they would have abandoned you. So forgive them, make istighfar on their behalf, and consult them in all affairs. You see, that love that the companions had for the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was not by accident. He demonstrated love to them. When one time Abu Bakr as-Siddiq had a fallout with Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhuma, and he said harsh words he wished he didn't say. So he asked Sayyidina Umar to forgive him. Sayyidina Umar said, "No, I'm not forgiving you." So Sayyidina Abu Bakr was very worried. He made a mistake, and the person he made the mistake against doesn't want to forgive him. So he went to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, explaining to him what happened. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam three times said, "Ghafara Allahu laka ya Abu Bakr. Ghafara Allahu laka ya Abu Bakr. Ghafara Allahu laka ya Abu Bakr. May Allah forgive you, Abu Bakr," three times. In the meantime, Sayyidina Umar felt guilty. He went to the house of Abu Bakr. He didn't find him. He went to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and the Prophet alayhi salam was upset with him because he refused to forgive his brother. And he started being, you know, tough with Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, to the point where Abu Bakr as-Siddiq himself, he was on his knees in front of the Prophet saying, "Ya Rasulullah, I am the one who made the mistake, not him." So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Inna Allah ba'athani ilaykum, faqultum kadabt." Wa qala Abu Bakr sadaq. Allah sent me to you, everyone said you are a liar, but Abu Bakr said he is saying the truth. وواساني بنفسي بنفسه ومالي. He supported me with himself, with his wealth. فهل أنتم تاركوا لي صاحبي؟ Are you going to leave my brother for me? Stop abusing him. فما أوذي بعد ذلك. No one touched Abu Bakr after that. Jalbib was a person, you can say, that opposite of handsomeness. He was not, his physiques were not nice. He was a poor man. But true believer, beloved by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He saw him one time, came from his back, put his hand on his eyes and said, "Who would buy this slave from me?" He's not a slave, just joking with him. And initially he said, "Leave me," but when he recognized his being hugged by the Prophet ﷺ, he said, "Tajiduni kasidan ya Rasulullah. I'm not worth anything to be sold, ya Rasulullah." So the Prophet ﷺ said, "But you are very valuable in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Jalbib. Why don't you get married, ya Jalbib?" He said, "I have nothing, ya Rasulullah. How can I get married?" He said, "I will help you get married. Go to so and so household of Ansar and tell them I am being sent by the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam." He did. Actually, he first invited the father and told him, "I want your daughter." That man was happy. Maybe the Prophet will marry her. He said, "Not for me, for Jalbib." "Oh, that poor guy? Let me check with her mother." As an excuse, he doesn't want to say no to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in his face. He goes, the mother said, "Absolutely not. My daughter will not be married to such a man." But the daughter was wise. And she said, "أَتَرُدُّونَ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَمْرًا." Are you rejecting the advice of Rasulullah صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ? اِدْفَعُونِ إِلَيْهِ فَإِنَّهُ لَنْ يُضَيَّعَنِي. Marry me to him. Rasulullah will never give an advice that wastes me. So Rasulullah made dua for her. قال اللهم صب عليها الخير صبا ولا تجعل عيشها كدا كدا. اللهم صب عليها الخير صبا صبا ولا تجعل عيشها كدا كدا. Ya Allah, shower her with her with the blessing, plenty of blessing, and don't give her any hardship in her life. She married Jilbib. A few days later, a call for jihad, and he leave his bride and join Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. After the battle, Rasulullah said, find who is killed. They mention important people, so and so. But he said, I am missing Jilbib, find Jilbib. And they find him surrounded by seven people that he killed before he got killed. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, هذا مني وأنا منه. He belongs to me and I belong to him. And he kept carrying his body in his hands until they finished digging the grave. Allahumma rda an, fa inni radin an. He's not a famous Sahabi, he's just a poor man who had true faith in his heart. Even people who made mistakes. In Khaybar, you know, that came after the prohibition of alcohol drinking. And there was plenty of wine in Khaybar stored by the Jews of Khaybar. So one of the people who used to love to drink, Abdullah al-Ansari, drank and got drunk. And this was before the whipping, the had. So Rasulullah wanted to teach him a lesson. So he ordered everyone to take his shoes and let's all hit him to teach him a lesson. And again, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, as usual, was very zealous. So he started cursing him. He's drunk. And Sayyidina Rasulullah said, don't curse him, Ya Umar. He loved Allah and his messenger. Abdullah listened to this. And he said, by Allah, I will never go back to alcohol or to drinking again because of the kindness he showed to someone who slipped. Ya Ahbab Rasulullah, I can go on and on and on. But this is your beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have to remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. If your fathers, your children, your spouses, your entire families and tribes, your businesses, your wealth, your homes are more beloved to you than Allah and His Messenger, so watch out until the command of Allah comes and Allah will not guide the rebellious ones. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, you will never taste the sweetness of faith. ثلاثة من وجدهن وجد حلاوة الإيمان. Three things, if you have them, you will taste the sweetness of faith. One of them, أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليهما مما سواهما. That Allah and His Messenger are more beloved than anything else. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة على المصطفى. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه في الأولين والآخرين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آل بيته وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وذريته وأصحابه وأنصاره ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Don't think that the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was limited to his companions or his generation. It actually extended to you and me. In the very last few days before his passing, alayhi salatu wa salam, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Al-Baqiyah, where the Muslims are buried, to bid them farewell. He felt his dying. And then he cried, alayhi salatu wa salam. And he said, إِنِّي أَشْتَاقُ إِلَىٰ إِخْوَانِي. I miss my brothers. The companion said, Ya Rasulullah, we are here with you. We are your brothers. He said, no, أنتم أصحاب, you are my companions. My brothers are generations that will come after me. They believe in me, but they never saw me. Then he asked them to give salam to every follower of his ummah. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving you and me and everyone else salam. What are we doing to return salam Rasulullah? Have we followed his teaching? Have we embodied his character? Have we taught our children who is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? إني داع فأمنه اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك ورسولك محمد في الأولين والآخرين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل بيننا شقيا ولا محروما اللهم اجعلنا ممن يتبعون سنة نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ويتخلقون بخلقه ويهتدون بهديه وبالنور الذي أنزلته على يديه يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا اللهم أصلح لنا أزواجنا اللهم أصلح لنا ذرياتنا اللهم يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث أغث عبيدك المسلمين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها اللهم ارحمنا فأنت بنا راحم ولا تعذبنا فأنت عليه قادر فأنت علينا قادر وصلي اللهم وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك رسولك محمد في الأولين والآخرين إنك حميد مجيد عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم